Hello everyone and welcome back to the Perfect French with Dylan. Today we have the most important lesson of the whole pronunciation course. We are going to talk about silent letters. So if there is one lesson that you should watch from the beginning to the end, it's this one. It's going to be long, we have a lot to see, but you should really watch it. If you have the book, this is the lesson 7, page 10 to 14. I told you there was a lot. We have so much to do that I have a table of contents for the video. So let's see it. The first one is when a is preceded by a vowel. Second one, a preceded by a consonant. A in the middle of the word. The last consonant of the word. Plural of words. Plural of verbs. And finally, actually this is three different ones, but I had to put it in one because I don't have enough space. The letters H, U, and M. Alright, so grab some water, some food if you want. We are going to see all that. The first point is a preceded by a vowel. So if the word ends with IE, we only pronounce I. Let's see. Une bougie. Une bougie. Because the lesson is very long, I'm not going to give you the English translation every time, but it's going to be on the screen. So here. Une bougie. I don't say une bougie. Okay? I say une bougie. Bougie, that's it. Bougie. I stop after the I. Okay? Next one. La pharmacie. La pharmacie. Si. Stop it. Last one. La librairie. La librairie. So I don't say librairie. Right? This is what we call a false friend. So for us, une librairie is a bookstore. An actual library is une bibliothèque. Next one for e preceded by a vowel again, we have a, I, e. We only pronounce a and e, but we don't say a, i. A, i together make the sound e. E. So we have la monnaie, la monnaie. Une plaie, une raie. So can you hear? I did not pronounce any of the E. This is very important, okay? Next one is when we have U and E. We only pronounce U. Une avenue, bienvenue. And the last one, une rue. Une rue. Next one, when we have O, I, E. O, I together make the sound wa. So let's see. La joie. La joie. La soie. La soie. Une wa. Une wa. So I don't explain you how to pronounce it, because we are going to come back on every single sound, every single letter in the course. So I'm not going to stop every time we see a new sound to explain you, you know, how to shape your mouth, where to place your tongue, etc. I'm going to explain you that just in the next lessons. Next one, O-U-E. O-U-E. If we remove the E, it makes the sound OU. OU. So we have la bourre. La bourre. La joue. La joue. La roue. La roue. Next one, E, U, E. E, U make the sound E. E. And this is actually an open E. There's a closed one and an open one. It's two different sounds. This one is an open one because it's the last sound of the word. We are also going to see that. First one. La banlieue. La banlieue. This one, la queue. La queue. So don't say que e, c'est que. So that was e preceded by a vowel. Now we are going to see e preceded by a consonant. So when e is after B, C, D, G, N, P, R, S, T, I hope I got them all, we don't pronounce the e. So let's see an example and then I'm going to explain you a bit more about it. If we have BE, we are only going to pronounce the B. So we have une robe, un tube, un verbe. So it can sound like we said the E at the end, but we actually don't. If we were saying the E, we'll say un verbe, we don't say that. We say un verbe. It's just the last, the final pronunciation of the B that make it sound like we pronounce the E, but we don't. Un verbe. So, for my very young students, I used to explain it like that, that the E is actually a bit of a superhero in French. And imagine you behind your computer being like, oh my gosh, she's totally crazy. That's going to make sense. So I always say that the E is kind of a superhero because it activates the letter before. It works really well with 6 years old. So whatever is before the E, we are going to pronounce it, but we're not going to pronounce the E, okay? The power of the E is transferred to the letter before. Because if we don't have the E, then we're not supposed to pronounce the last letter. Technically, there are a ton of exceptions and what if and what if that we are going to see in this course, but technically this is the main rule. So we don't pronounce the final E, but we pronounce the letter before. If there was no E, the last letter would not be pronounced. Make sense? Let's see another one. If the ending of the word is CE, we remove the E and then we keep only the sound of the C, which is going to be S. So we have une chance. S, okay? Une chance. So I just pronounce the S at the end instead of the C. I don't say une chance. That doesn't work. Une chance. Next one. Une lance. Une lance. And finally, une ronce. Une ronce. Next one, we have DE. We pronounce only the D. First one, chaude. Chaude. Froide. Froide. Une balade. Une balade. So here, let's take the two first one and check out the pronunciation if there is no E at the end. It will be chaud, froid. I would not pronounce the last letter, which is D. So do you understand why we have the E at the end now? It activates the letter before. If we didn't have the E, the pronunciation will be totally different. And the next one is GE. We keep only the G and it's pronounced like a J. 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 Je change. Je change. Un lange. Un lange. That could actually be a sentence. Je change un lange. I change a diaper. This one would not be a part of the sentence. Je mange. Je mange. So the first je, and the last je, same pronunciation, okay? Je mange. Je mange. The only difference is that we pronounce the E with je, but not mange. Next one, NE, we keep only the N. Well, no, we keep both. We pronounce only the N. Une semaine. Une semaine. Féminine. 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 So here, if there is no E at féminine, the pronunciation will be féminin. Féminin. That would be a totally different pronunciation because the IN at the end makes the sound A. Féminin. I told you, the E activates the letter before. And the last one, un téléphone. Un téléphone. Okay? Now we have PE. We pronounce only the P. La coupe. La coupe. Une pipe. Une pipe. Une jupe. Une jupe. Next one, RE. I know that the R, the French R, is your favorite sound. I know that. So we have un laboratoire. Un laboratoire. Une coiffure. Une coiffure. La gare. La gare. This one is very interesting because we pronounce the S as a Z. Let's see. Une chaise. Z. Une chaise. Une entreprise. Une entreprise. Une valise. Une valise. I just realized that now that I put a lot with ESE, it doesn't have to do anything with that. Last one for this category, we are not done. TE, we pronounce only the T. Une fête. Une fête. Une tête. Une tête. Une carotte. Une carotte. That's it for the E preceded by a consonant. Now we are going to see E in the middle of the word. Sometimes we have word with E in the middle that we do not pronounce. We are going to see more examples when we see the letter E, but there's not really a rule. Sometimes we don't pronounce it, sometimes we pronounce it. But let's see a few. Un paiement. Un paiement. Un remerciement. Un remerciement. Une promenade. Promenade. Une promenade. A walk. Okay, so did you hear that I did not pronounce the E at all? But E is pronounced in little words, especially the two or the three letters word, such as de, le, me, je, te, que, ce, ne, etc. So when you see two-letter words or three-letter words like those one, make sure to pronounce the E at the end. Now let's see the silent letters when it's the last consonant of the word. So for B, we have le plomb. Le plomb. So I don't say plombe, I say plomb. We have only a few for B, so I just put one up with the most common. Now with C, un banc. Un banc. So I don't say un banc, c'est un banc. Next one, blanc. Blanc. Now with D, we have le nid. Le ni, and we have sourd, sourd. So that's an adjective. So if we add a E to make it a feminine adjective, it's going to be sourde, then we pronounce the D. But because there's no E at the end, we don't pronounce the D. Sourd. Next one is F. So we have un cerf, un cerf, le nerf. Le nerf. When the last letter is G, such as le point, we don't say poing, we say point, but that does not include English words, such as smoking, camping, etc. So when the word comes from English and it ends with ing, we pronounce the G, but not point, because point doesn't come from English, okay? Next one, with the last consonant is L. Un outil. Un outil. Un fusil. Un fusil. Next one, P. We have beaucoup. Beaucoup. I don't say beaucoup. Beaucoup. Another very common one, trop. Trop. Okay, when the last consonant is S, and that does not include the plural that we are going to see after. So this is just how the word is spelled, even in singular. Un bras. Un bras. Le repos. Le repos. Okay, so I don't say repos, and I don't say bras. Now with the T, we have l'art, l'art, Le concert. Le concert. Un dessert. Un dessert. Now when the word ends with a X, so once again for this one it's not about plural. Sometimes the plural of word in French ends with a X. This is not about plural. That's just how the word is spelled. So we have un choix, choix, no X. On say choix. Une croix, and a very common one, deux, deux, no X. Well, we don't pronounce it. The last one of the consonant is the Z. We have le nez, chez, chez. So those two are very particular because technically a Z makes the sound E. But still, we don't say nez, we don't say chaise, so I still included them in, just to make sure that you know the pronunciation. And one without the EZ is du riz. Du riz, some rice. So that's it about this category. Now we can start the plural of words. So the plural of words, we have two different possibilities in French. We have either S or X, so we're going to start with S. So when we have un chien, des chiens. Un chien, des chiens. I don't say des chiens, okay? I say un chien, des chiens. Next one. Un téléphone, des téléphones. Un téléphone, des téléphones. So here we don't pronounce the E, and here we don't pronounce the ES. And the last one. Une table, des tables. Une table, des tables. So table, table. Same pronunciation. So sometimes, like I said, the plural is also a X in French. So we have un hibou, des hiboux. Un hibou, des hiboux. Un gâteau, des gâteaux. Un gâteau, des gâteaux. Un cheveu, des cheveux. Un cheveu, des cheveux. That was quite easy for the plural of words. Now we have the plural of verbs. So when I say the plural of verbs, I mean the one with il and elle. You are going to understand. They usually end with ent. So let's see a few examples. We have il chante. Il chante. Il chante. Il chante. So we literally have no way to know if it's plural or not. Because il chante, even the il is pronounced exactly the same, since we don't pronounce the S. Okay? Il and il. Chante and chante. I know that's complicated. So this is why spelling in French is extremely important, because otherwise it just doesn't make any sense. If you talk about a few person and you write just after il chante singular, well, it doesn't make any sense if you want to read it. Let's see another one. Il mange. Il mange. Il mange. Il mange. So they stay exactly the same. Another one. Elle dort. This one is going to change a tiny bit. Elle dorme. Elle dort. Elle dorme. So she sleeps, they sleep. Why do we have a difference here between the two verbs? This one is not a verb ending in er, so this is an irregular verb. So this is why there is a difference. We are on the last point of the lesson. We are going to see the letter H, U, and M. Let's start with the letter H at the beginning of the word. This one, we just saw it, we have un hibou. Un hibou. So the H at the beginning, we don't pronounce it. H in French are very hard to understand. They act either as a consonant or as a voyelle. We are going to come back on H during this course. It's going to be an important lesson as well. Next one, un héros. Un héros. Don't pronounce the H. Last one, une haie. Une haie. Don't pronounce the H either. But sometimes the H is not at the beginning of the word, but it's in the middle. So we have un véhicule. Véhicule. So the H kind of act as a separation between the voyelles. Un véhicule. Une trahison. Une trahison. N'un U. When U is after a Q, we don't pronounce the U. So this one we saw it as well. Une queue. Une queue. So I don't say queue. I say queue. We don't pronounce the U. Next one. Un quart. Un quart. We don't pronounce the U as well. Another time that we don't pronounce the U is when it's after G. Longue. Longue. So here, because we have the U and the E that we don't pronounce, the only letter that I pronounce is G. Longue. G. Okay? Longue. Another one. Une langue. Une langue. And the last one that I included here is the M. We have more than that. We have also sometimes the P in the middle, the G in the middle. I did not include all of them. We are going to see them, all the exceptions, all the little what if and what not. In this course, I just wanted to add the M because it's a very common one with a word that you all know. So we have l'automne. L'automne. You most likely know this word. So we don't pronounce the M, we say l'automne. Tonne. O-tonne. That's it. And another one that's not that common is condamné. Condamné. Né. We don't pronounce the M. We don't say condamné. Condamné. Now that would be hard to pronounce. We say condamné. That's it. That was a very long lesson, but thank you for staying until the end. Let me know if you have a question in the comment section. I try to answer comments every single day. Tomorrow the lesson is going to be about contraction. So I will see you tomorrow. À demain.